The RDA for zinc is 11 milligrams per day for adult males and 9 milligrams a day for females. Approximately 8% of the U.S. population has inadequate zinc intake, and up to 45% of people 60 and older have inadequate zinc intake. Zinc deficiency in the U.S. is rare. People that consume alcohol or are vegetarian may require more zinc. Alcohol increases zinc excretion by 50%. Vegetarians are getting their zinc from plant sources, which has zinc bound to phytate and lowers its bioavailability. Vegetarians are getting their zinc from plant sources, which has zinc bound to phytate and lowers bioavailability. Vegetarians may need to consume up to 50% more of the RDA for zinc in order to get adequate levels. Zinc has been shown to play a role in pneumonia. A randomized controlled trial in about 600 elderly individuals given a multivitamin that contained zinc for 1 year found those individuals with the highest zinc levels after supplementation were almost 50% less likely to get pneumonia. Another randomized controlled trial in hospitalized children found that 20 milligrams of zinc per day reduced pneumonia symptoms by 30% compared to a placebo. A meta-analysis of 6 randomized controlled trials found that zinc supplementation in children reduced pneumonia prevalence by 41%. Zinc has also been shown to play a role in the common cold. A meta-analysis of 3 trials found that supplementation with zinc acetate lozenges, around 80 to 90 milligrams a day, found that they had a 3-fold faster recovery rate from the common cold compared to a placebo. Another meta-analysis of 7 separate trials using either zinc acetate or zinc gluconate lozenges found they reduced the common cold duration by 33% compared to placebo. Doses lower than 75 milligrams per day have not been shown to have an effect on the common cold. So let's touch a little bit on zinc and immune function. Studies have shown that mild zinc deficiency may decrease immune function, including dysfunctional cytokine production in T cells and regeneration not occurring in CD4 positive T cells. Multiple in vitro studies have found that zinc inhibits the replication of RNA viruses. But this is in vitro. Zinc is a positively charged ion, so it cannot get into the cell without a transporter. But there is another way that zinc can get into the cell without a transporter. A zinc ionophore can help transport zinc across the cell plasma membrane, and this can help zinc get into the cell.